Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. This is going to be the second to last blue and gold coin collecting hunt we're going to do until we, you know, get to some new levels. I basically just want to clear out the first four levels 100% before I move on to something else. So that's basically why I'm doing it this way. So, Gelato Beach, here we come! Now, what you're going to want to do first is go over to shine number 4 and then go to the sandbird area. On second thought, I'm gonna look for something over here. There should be like a shine sprite. Oh, here we go, shine sprite picture. That'll give you a blue coin. Hello, thank you. Over here next to that shine sprite picture, you're gonna see a red cataquack. Ah, I should have jumped on it. I should have sprayed it first. Whoops, my bad. No, not you. No, not. Oh. Well, only the red ones cause damage anyway, so yeah. Spray and jump, and there's a blue coin. Way over here where the sandcastle was, there should be another shine sprite picture. This one's huge, and it gives you another blue coin. And now we're in the sandbird area. This is why I selected the shine to begin with, but I thought I would collect a few odd coins first off, you know, like right off the bat. Don't even bother with the red coins this time, just focus on the blue coins. The first one that will be coming up will be to your left here. You see on this cloud, just grab it like that, and whoa, I should have saved that. Whoa, that's okay. I'll save on the next coin. You want to go over to the right side for the next two blue coins. Oh, wait, here. There it is right there. It's not too far to the right like I expected, but it's still on the right side. Oh, there is... Hey, no, I am not going to leave without that coin, thank you. And stay on... No, I need to get up to... Uh-oh, I'm boned. I can't get back up to the sandbird. I gotta restart. Okay, see that third cloud that's coming up there? You can just barely see the blue coin on top of it. So this time, avoid that second cloud, and just wait for the third cloud to drift towards you, or I should say, we drift towards the third cloud, and... Oops, wait. Oh, wait, it's flipping over! Oh, man, I didn't know that! Shoot, I forgot! Okay, this time I'm on the tail, so I'll be able to, you know, do the flip, well, not flip, do the walk over like that, and... Oh boy. Oh, I got it. Awesome. So that's coin number 3 in the sandbird area. There's only one more here, and it's quite far along this preset track that it's going on. Once again, let's look on the bottom side of the sandbird and look at the hollow spots of it, which are quite weird, I must say. And get ready to flip. There we go. Okay, when's the fourth one coming? There it is right there. I don't know if I want to be on the head or if I want to be... like, on the tail again, because I don't remember if... because I know it flips again once more. Wait, it's coming up there? Oh, gotta get on it! There we go, that's the last one of the sandbird area. Well, I guess I just have to leave now. Goodbye, cruel world! Okay, for the rest of the blue coins, select shine number 6. You'll be able to get every single one that's left over on this one. What you're first going to want to do when you get here is climb up on top of this hut here, and then... Thank you, Mario. I was wondering if he was going to get up there. And then go over to here, and you'll see the rocket nozzle. You're going to need this for a few coins, so make sure to unlock this. Oh, wait, there we go. This is what I was looking for, this shine sprite picture. And there we go. I missed that one. Now, if you look over here by where the sandcastle was, you're going to see that there's a Yoshi egg. It wants a pair. At least, it wants a pair for me. So, let's go get it a pair. There's two fruit stands, I should say two places in this level where you can get fruit. There's one over here, and I think this is the one that I'll need. Yep, right here has the pear, so grab that. The second one that has fruit is... where is it? Ah, this place right here. There is a pineapple here. No, that's not a pineapple, that's a durian. And I thought there was something else around here. I thought there was... Ah, coconuts are up there if you need them. Okay, so let's give this to Yoshi, and use him to get 2 coins in this level. Level 6 exclusive coins. I should say Episode 6 exclusive coins. That you need Yoshi's Vomit for. Of course, you have to have a vomiting dinosaur slash dragon. It's not a party without a vomiting dinosaur slash dragon. Anyway, you go over to here and you're gonna see that there is some kind of force field-like thing. Yep, spray it to get rid of it and then inflict this thing with vomit, and sure enough, there is a place with a blue coin. The next thing that you're gonna wanna do with Yoshi here is look for a bee's nest. Yeah, another bee's nest. And it's somewhere around here. I gotta look for... Wait. There it is! Let's eat the bees first so I don't, like... Ah! Don't get knocked off my ride here, but that failed anyway. Just eat a few bees on the outside just to make sure you don't get knocked off your ride. You know, while you're spraying it, because then they'll pop out and they'll tick you off, and then you're gonna have to respray the hive. You know that problem. Okay. There should only be 3 bees on the outside. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. You can't do it, can you? I'm too close by. There we go. Eat the bees! Eat the bees like crazy! Don't let them get away! There isn't too many bees in this hive, so it shouldn't take you too long. There's your coin. Goodbye, my water-soluble friend! Wait, what? He doesn't dissolve in this guess it must just be deep water that he dissolves in. So goodbye, my water-soluble friend! What in the world? He's surviving! Oh, there we go. Anyway, what I want to do now is clear out the coins in the water, just to keep things organized. You're gonna see a coin right off the coast of this island here, right at the very start. So, dive in the water and collect it. Like so. Alright, back on top of these trees. I believe I can get up there pretty easily. Wait, it's not this tree, is it? It's one of these trees, I'm sure of it. Let's just try and go up this... Hey, Mario, work with me here. Go up this tree, like, no... Maybe I should get the rocket nozzle over there. Well, at least right now I can go ahead and get this blue coin. And yeah, I lost the rocket nozzle when I, grabbed onto Yoshi. I should say rode Yoshi for some reason. It automatically resets your nozzles for some reason. So maybe I'll just do it like this, and hover to the coin. There we go. Okay, go up this tree. It's the one with the swing on it. Let's try and spin up there if you can. Get on a leaf so you don't fall down. There we go. Okay, from the top of this tree, you're gonna see a blue coin way in the water over here with the school of fish. Yes, it travels with the fish. Don't let it go into the sand, so try and stay low. And then go up to it, kind of like that. Okay, for the next blue coin that I'm gonna do near the water, get a fruit. Any kind of fruit will do. No, I don't think so, guy. No way, Jose. So, now remember those spinning blades on top of the fruit hut? Take a fruit and drop it into the spinning blades, and for whatever reason, it'll give you a blue coin. Can I just, like, plop it in there? There we go! I didn't want to throw it accidentally. And then what you're going to want to do is go underneath the fruit hut and swim under it. I believe it's under these boards here. And come on, camera. There we go! There's another blue coin right there. And I forgot this. I mean, I didn't forget the save. I clipped through it too quickly, excuse me. While I was holding the, control stick down. Now, there's 2 schools of fish over here as well in this coral reef. They constantly change positions, so you're gonna have to look around here pretty hard. They're usually around the outer edges, so it's easier to collect the coin that way, so keep swimming around the edges until you see blue coin fish. Wait, I see a blue coin over there. Is that one of the schools of fish? Or is that just the just another underwater coin, excuse me. Because maybe that other school of fish that I collected was one of the schools of fish that I was looking for? Yeah, I think this is just a stationary blue coin. Or maybe not. Maybe this is, this is another moving blue coin. So these schools of fish really move around quite a bit here. Then there was another stationary blue point somewhere around here, underwater, or at least I thought there was. Because I only recall there being two schools of fish. Aha! Here's the other stationary coin. The other ones were school of fish ones, so I already collected both fish school coins there. And deep, deep underwater here, you're going to see a coin. And it's quite hard to see from a distance, that's why I couldn't see it. But it is... I'll swim all the way up to the surface and switch the camera around. You are way, way, way over here. See where I am? Just swim out to this point and you'll see the coin. Okay, if you look up in the treetops here, next to where the sandbird egg was, there's going to be a cataquack in this tree, and spray it, jump on it, and get a blue coin from it. Hey, give me... Come on. Thank you! And I just realized I forgot yet another Shine Sprite picture right over here near the beginnings. Keep spraying, da 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 da, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go, grab the blue coin. Oh, and I keep forgetting to show off this guy here. As long as I'm around the area, yeah, he'll say, oh, it's all I got, it's so bright, and yeah, he'll give me some sunglasses and everything will go very dark. Yeah, that's what that guy does, basically, is that he gives you just sunglasses. But later on, he'll give you a t-shirt. I believe it's once you beat the game, he'll give you a t-shirt along with it. It's like a Shine Sprite print t-shirt or something like that. So I'll just show that off for the remainder of these coins. Anyway, you're going to see over here, there is a triangle on the wall. I bet you know what to do here! Oh, yes! Now, way on the other side of the beach there, I'm gonna try and slide all the way to it, just to go extra fast, all the way to this triangle, and... No, don't get caught in the water, Mario, thank you! So there is that coin, and now I'm gonna do it the opposite way for the other coin, and whoop! So now I should be able to just slide on my belly to go over there as well. Whee! Look at me go! Go, Mario, go! There we go. I probably should have did this a little earlier, but where you get the rocket nozzle, you know, getting up here, there's an M. Guess what you have to do here? Yep. Remember up here where we got the watermelon? Well, there should be two blue birds up here. There's one. Wait, that's a blue coin. Curse these sunglasses! Anyway, I should at least get this blue coin as long as I'm here. That was a pretty good rocket jump there. The other blue coin that you can get with the rocket nozzle on these tight ropes up here is way on that side, but I'd really like to get the blue birds real quick here. Oh, there's one of them. Can I spray it? Can I spray it? Can I get it with a water droplet? Ugh. It's like all the critters in this game are water soluble. You got Yoshi, you got some birds, and I got the bird a couple times there. Come on, come on. Please. I would like... You have bird for lunch, or you know, a blue coin in my wallet, that would work too. Oh man. Jesus! Oh, at least it landed. Oh, there we go. And I just seen the other blue bird go by, so let's just grab this coin. And the other blue bird was flying in the sky. Oops. Somewhere. Where was it anyway? I lost sight of it. Arr, I hate the birds! Wait, is that it? No, that's a green one in the distance there. Okay, we're looking for... blueness. There it is, there it is. It landed on the wire. Go, 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 go! Kill it, kill it, kill it! Dang it! Oh, wait, I think I got it. Yeah, I got it. Woo! And... get it, get it, get it! No! Dang it! I don't think I'm gonna get it before it disappears. Go! And yes! Well, as long as I'm in the area with the rocket nozzle, go on top of this cabana hut here, and at the very top of it, just do a little rocket boost plus a jump, and you'll get a blue coin. Now, you see those wires off to the right there? That's where I'm going next. You can get over there pretty easily if you just jump up here, then jump up to here, and get on this wire. Flip, there we go. And can I get up to any wires from over here? I'm not sure, actually. I'm going to get across here as quickly as I possibly can. You need the rocket nozzle to get up here, and yeah, I see that blue coin down there. I'll be down there in just a minute. Wah! Awesome, I got up here. And now what you want to do is get up to this one, and carefully make your way to this wire. This is where it's going to get a little bit dangerous, because if you fall down, you pretty much have to climb back up again, and there's your blue coin. Now let's go over to that other one off to the side. No. Time it. There we go. Get over in this alcove here, and there's a blue coin. Let me drop. No. Mario, why are you not working with me today? Come on. Wall kick. Or side flip doesn't work. This camera is not working with me here. There we go. Oh, I forgot all about this one. If you go by Glasses Guy here and look up into this beach house's ceiling, you're gonna see a blue coin. Yep. Right there. And that's the last coin of the level. Whew! Glad that's done and over with. Took over 30 minutes or so far on this part, which I'll be cutting down greatly. And I'm getting rid of these dang sunglasses. There! It's nice and bright again. To the gold coin hunt! Actually, I forgot to trade it into Mr. Tanuki and Sun here. You know, trade in those 30 blue coins that I got there for 3 shine sprites. So let's do it right now. Why would I want to refund that? Jeez. Alright, for the gold coin hunt, I recommend Episode 8, The Watermelon Festival. Here we go! Oh, may I add that this is the first level in the game that you won't be able to collect 100... Oh, wait, you... Excuse me, never mind, I'm thinking of some other level. That, I was gonna say that you can collect 100 coins in on some episodes, but no, wait, this... You can collect all the gold... I should say 100 gold coins on this one here. So what you're gonna want to do to start off right off the bat is go to this offshore island here, and start spraying. Let's get a little bit of Mario! Anyway, I think I should probably explain why I wasn't making very many Super Mario Sunshine parts in a while, since I explained this in my new Super Mario Brothers Wii walkthrough, I think it was. Yeah, it was definitely that one. I made a video on it before, but I decided to take it down because I was in like a really bad mood, so I think I came off like really ornery. So that's why I took it down, obviously. And anyway, I think I'll re-explain it here while I collect these gold coins. Basically, I had trouble with both my video editor and the YouTube annotation editor. With my video editor, it would constantly crash for seemingly no reason, but it would do it on the same, you know, same actions, but it wouldn't give me like an error code or anything like that. So I didn't know how to fix it, but eventually it stopped working altogether, like it just wouldn't run at all, but then it gave me an error. It said that QuickTime was problematic for some reason. I was like, why is QuickTime messing up on me? I don't know, but when I reinstalled QuickTime, it started working again. It was just so weird. Maybe like there was a bad update or something and it glitched. And that's what screwed it up, because I guess my video editor requires QuickTime to even run. I don't know why it would need that. I mean, I would think a program, you know, should be working in itself. Or at least that's what I would think, you know, logically. But evidently that's not the case, so... At least that's fixed right now, because that was the main issue that I had there for a while, because that was just plain frustrating. These cataquacks give you 1 coin a piece, so make sure to spray each and every one of them for a coin. They're very, very helpful in this one for getting coins, and it's also pretty quick to get coins through them as well. Anyway, as I was saying, as for the YouTube annotation editor, what happened with that is, you know, when I do this game, I put the links at the end of each shine or... at the end of each shine, excuse me, with annotation, and they link through the menu system that I made for this, and I just kind of terraformed that tree there. There was evidently something covering up that tree that I didn't see there, but oh well. Anyway, as I was saying, well, the annotation editor kept glitching up. No, I'm not gonna die from you. No way, man. The annotation editor kept glitching up, and what would happen is that if I would copy and paste the same link into two different annotations, whether I made them new or they were old annotations, you know, like made at the same time or something like that, and I was just copying and pasting them, whatever. No matter what, it would delete the link in the annotation and sometimes delete the annotation itself, which, you know, is just really frustrating in and of itself because of the fact that my annotations, you know, the annotations are kind of like the bulk of this walkthrough to kind of hold the whole thing together or put it all together, basically. So, you know, I don't even know right now if the parts in, you know, in their entirety have all their annotations working, or they're all there. Oh no, I'm not gonna die due to catastrophe this time, man. Oh no, never again. But yeah, so if anyone reports any annotations, you know, that aren't working, just send me a message and I'll fix them. You know, if they're not leading to the right spots and stuff like that, and I'll check them over. Evidently, I already did that cataquack there. But anyway, just keep killing off the cataquacks. Well, you can't kill them off, excuse me, but you can, you know, flip them for a loop there. Those watermelons, I actually have to do something with those watermelons to get a bunch of coins from them. I'll show you what I have to do with them a little bit later, but as for now, just keep spraying the cataquacks here. Did I get you? I'm not sure if I got you. No, I didn't get you. Okay. This takes a while to do, naturally, because there's a lot of cataquacks, so there's a lot of coins associated with the cataquacks, and you get the idea. Yeah, just keep... Try and do it in, like, a pattern that you can follow so that you won't miss any cataquacks, because that would kind of suck, really. Yeah, that's really all there is to this explanation that I have here about the whole Super Mario Sunshine dilemma that I had there. I mean, it was just, like, really frustrating, and I felt that I was even being a bit snippy with people lately because of that, because it was... Because, you know, making videos should be fun. You know, it's a part of a hobby. A hobby is there to unwind from certain things. And if you don't have that, you know, it gets really, really irritating to not have something to unwind with, you know? And then I felt like I was being snippy with people, as I said. So I'm sorry if I was for a while there. And I think I got all the cataquacks. So I'm just going to end it off there. Now, what you want to do with all the watermelons that you find around here... Pop them all. Yes, pop all the watermelons. 10 times a piece for coins. Yes. You'll get one coin for each pop. And, or you can just, you know, have a cataquack pop it for you. Or what you can do is take the watermelons over by the fruit stand, which is what I might just do to get 10 coins. That way it'll be a little bit faster that way, maybe. Unless the cataquacks will get in my way. So maybe I'll give this a shot. I don't really approve of this method, obviously, because of the cataquack issue. Because they hunt you down, they hunt the watermelons down. They are a big problem left and right. But these watermelons aren't as hard to push as the ones, or I should say that ginormous one way at the top of the hill. That one's a real, real problem. So anyway, no. You are gonna go up there safely, and oh, I said safely, not into the water. At least I'll get a coin if it falls into the water, because that's my main goal here, is 100 gold coins. So let's just get it over to the hut. See, it's not that hard to push this one across because it's small, and he's gonna say it's not a winning watermelon, but that's okay. But he's still gonna... Oh my god, they fly all over the place! Oh man, I can't have that! They're gonna disappear before I get to them. Okay, maybe it's best if you were to pop them one at a time. You know, get one coin a piece individually, but yeah, you can get 10 coins that way as well. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pop the coins around this beach, and I'll see you when I'm done. I mean, excuse me, pop the watermelons around here, and I'll see you when I'm done popping them all. Okay, I'm up here with Ginormo, and let's see if I can, there we go, pop it 10 times. up on top of this cabana where you got the blue points from, you can collect the gold coins. Underneath this fruit stand, if you recall that blue coin that was under here, you might as well get the gold coins that are here as well, and yeah, you can climb on the ceiling here. Underneath the Fruit Hut Cabana area here, there's a bunch of coins that you can go ahead and collect, providing that the camera works with you. I guess I can just do it without being able to see anything here, but it would definitely work better if the camera was working. Well, you've got 94 coins up to this point. I'm pretty sure there's a watermelon I missed somewhere, so let's go find that watermelon. Well, there's two coins back here I forgot about, and I also know of a few more coins on top of these tightropes, so maybe this would be the better place to go and get those remaining few coins. Let's just try and... Aw, man, get up there. Hold on. Alright, up here. The last four coins! Woo! And it goes to the sandcastle area, so let's go over there. By the way, if you didn't see, there was a couple more... Get out of sand, Mario! If you look up here, there's a couple more coins that you can get with the rocket nozzle or some other method, I think, if you really need them above that fruit hut. But I really don't think you're gonna need them, as I... it was actually two coins off, thanks to that watermelon exploding out of the fruit stand. But yeah, here's your shine, and I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you in the next part.